Hi, I'm Kelly from Team Kool-Aid, and welcome to Let's Punch Out the World Eater, a Let's Play of the Elder Scrolls Skyrim Special Edition, and approximately 20-30 player-made mods. And with that, let's get started. Now, there's a lot of Skyrim mods to let you play very, very pretty characters, or you can play an orc. Race menu, this mod lets you save and load presets, so I will load one I made earlier. Play around with the height just a little bit. Warpaint. Where is Warpaint? Warpaint. This is alternate start, live another life. So we are not starting on the cart, starting in a nice little cell, set up mods. SkyUI's mod configuration menu. Get the camera off my back and up above my head. I don't like the default over the shoulder camera. I found over shoulder cameras make me motion sick, so this looks good. Need to pull it back just a little more. We'll cover more of this a little bit. Okay, camera distance is good. This is a test. I'm doing this let's play partially to test an unarmed mod called, I'm calling Physical Adept Round 2 at the moment. And gotta remember to enable it before we can do anything. Can take those perks later, once I have points to spend. Now talk to the Avatar of Mara.
Approach, my child, and choose where your new life shall begin. Which side of the war are you on? Ah, the Imperial Legion. Such noble souls. Fight well, citizen.
Let's check sound levels real quick. Make another save. And get out of here.
Tell me again why I'm wasting men chasing after a fairy tale.
If Ulfric gets his hand on that crown, it won't be a fairy tale. It'll be a problem.
Don't you Nords put any stock in your own traditions? I thought the Moot chose the king. We're backing Elisif.
Take off that stupid hat.
They'll do the sensible thing.
Not everyone's agreed to the Moot. You've been here long enough to know that Nords aren't always sensible. We follow our hearts.
So what? Ulfric gets this crown and then suddenly he's High King?
No, it's not as simple as that. But the Jagged Crown would be a potent symbol for his cause to rally around. But if we found it first...
And we gave it to Elisif.
In the absence of the Moot, it would further legitimize her claim.
Perhaps. I'm entrusting you with what resources I can spare. But I'm warning you, if this turns out to be a waste of time and men...
It won't be a waste.
Make sure you take the auxiliary here. You You can send her back when you get there and find nothing but old bones and cobwebs.
The Stone Fist's no fool. He's found the crown, but we'll get to it first. The Stone Fist's no fool. He's found the crown, but we'll get to it first.
This is the best part of the Legion. Listening to Colonel Ty and Commander Ivanova give you your orders.
Welcome to the Legion, Auxiliary. Listen up. Welcome to the Legion, Auxiliary. Listen up. Ulfric's right-hand man, Galmar Stonefist, has located what he believes is the final resting place of the Jagged Crown. We're going to make sure he doesn't get his hands on it. The rest of my men are already assembling outside Corvinjune. I'll meet you there as soon as I finish up here. A legendary crown, dating back to King Harald's time, or before. A powerful relic of a golden age, long since passed. Legend has it that the crown is made from the bones and teeth of ancient dragons, and is said to increase the power of the wearer. Whatever the truth, if Ulfric gets his hands on it, it would be a powerful symbol around which to rally support for his cause. Well, to be frank, we don't. Its location was lost with King Borgus when the Great Hunt killed him off while on his Leshen campaigns. Supposedly, his body was brought back to Skyrim and secretly buried with the crown. Knowledge of that location was lost in the Wars of Secession. But my agents report that Galmar is pretty damn convinced Corvinjune is the tomb of King Borgus. I know Galmar. We fought in many wars together. He's not a sentimental man taken to fancy. If he believes the crown is there, he's likely found it. I hope Ulfric will come to his senses, but I fear he's in too far to stop now. Likely only Ulfric's death or the overthrow of the Jarl supporting him will end this. Either way, much blood will be spilled. Don't wait for me. Get to Corvinjune as soon as you're ready. I'll meet you there.
Is it Orc?
Position.
Traitor! You betrayed
us! With it!
You should tell her that her uncle is scum that betrayed his High King. Best she know now, Advar.
All heart.
Rogvir, you helped Ulfric Stormcloak escape the city after he murdered High King Torig. By opening that gate for Ulfric, you betrayed the people of Solitude.
He doesn't deserve to speak!
There was no murder. Ulfric challenged Torig. He beat the High King in fair combat. Such is our way. Such is the ancient custom of Skyrim and all Nords.
Day, I go to Sovngarde.
Some gate guard you were!
Feel free to make requests.
I'd be a lot warmer and a lot happier with a belly full of mead.
You and me both, sister.
Seems there's no end to the needs of the Imperials. But what can I help you with? Yep. I just have one question for you. Light, medium, or heavy? They don't make finer steel anywhere else. If this doesn't keep you from dying, nothing will. Now that's it. One free outfit per soldier. You lose that, or get it banged up. You'll need to pay like everyone else. Return anytime you need arms or armor. My forge never rests.
So much better than that stupid dress. You can see physical adept doing its thing there.
I've got some salmon to sell.
Dean Inga says a bard can never have enough practice. So, would you like a tune?
Sibyl Stentor has a grasp of magical theory that I would never have expected from a human, even a Breton. No. That honor is Sibyl Stentor's. A smart man steers clear of Stentor, and keeps himself out of the dungeon when she's having a bad day. Let's just say that the headsman's axe may not be the worst way for a solitude jail prisoner to die. Look at that. I've told you to watch your tongue, and mine is waggling. I've said enough. I make sure Erica keeps breathing. You are free to leave.
Oh, hello. Just tidying up.
Wait for the NPCs to talk a bit.
Watch your feet. We just clean there.
Whatever, lady. And the scene seems to be stuck. I just want a quick chat with the court wizard.
Please, don't interrupt the court.
Don't interrupt what? Wait. Ah, that cleared it up.
I swear to you, unnatural magics are coming from that cave. There are strange noises and lights. We need someone to investigate.
Then we will immediately send out a legion to scour the cave and secure the town. Hafengar's people will always be safe under my...
Your Eminence, my scrying has suggested nothing in the area. Dragonbridge is under Imperial control. This is likely superstitious nonsense.
Perhaps a more tempered reaction might be called for.
Oh, yes, of course, you were right. Falk, tell Captain Aldous I said to assign a few extra soldiers to Dragonbridge.
Thank you, Jarl Elisif. What about the cave?
I will have someone take care of the cave as well, Varnus. Rest easy. You're dismissed. Do you have business with the court?
Be quick. I have little patience for mundane concerns. So, you wish to master the arcane arts? Take care of yourself, and always remember, the world is ripe with people looking to spill your blood.
I am the Jarl Steward. If you have court business to tend to, you talk to me.
More physical adept spells. We'll show you what they do later. When we have things to punch.
I better get back to Dragonbridge.
If it's arms or armor you need, see Baron in Castle Dower. Bloody good blacksmith, that one.
Please, take pity on an old madman.
Oh, thank you. Divines bless your kind heart.
My master has abandoned me, abandoned his people, and nothing I say can change his mind. Now he refuses to even see me. He says I interrupt his vacation. It's been so many years. Won't you please help? Oh, you just don't understand. Without him, I am not free. Without him, I am doomed. All of his empire shall fall into chaos. Last I saw him, he was visiting a friend in the Blue Palace. But no one as mundane as the Jarl. No, no. Such people are below him. No, he went into the forbidden wing of the palace to speak with an old friend. Said it had been ages since they had last had tea. Oh, and you'll need the hip bone. It's very important. No entering Pelagius's wing without that.
I'll get to that later. Right now, got a bunch of rebels to punch out. You'll see why they deserve it when you meet Ulfric Stormcloak in person. Okay, Solitude's here. And of course, Corvinjund is way over here. I am not walking all that way.
be a lot warmer and a lot happier with a belly full of me.
The guards do not have very many lines.
Need a ride?
Wait, was that a ride you said?
What is it, Orc?
The guardsman, again, trying to walk through walls.
My car, where do you want to go?
White Run should be closest to Corvungund.
We'll be off.
Head there.
Never been to White Run before? The Jarl's Palace is something to see. Dragon Search, they call it.
And of course, it's 2 a.m. when I get here. We seem to have a Khajiit caravan free of Khajiit. Oh well, ready for a nighttime assault on a Stormcloak. On a Draugr tomb. Nobody cares if you take their wheat and never give it back. Don't ask me why. But it makes good healing potions.
I think she's telling the truth.
I'm not going anywhere. Now back off before I do something drastic.
She doesn't have the scar.
What? Oh, you're right.
We've made a mistake. Now move along before that mouth of yours gets you into trouble.
Next time you're looking to pester someone, make sure it's the right person. Foreigners. What a nuisance. They thought I was some other Red Guard woman. They just wouldn't leave me alone. I hope they get lost in the wilderness.
And what that's all about will be revealed in another quest. That time I got to actually hit something. Okay, giants are kind of territorial and hit really hard. Not going through their camp. Oh, look. More puppies.
Situation.
Welcome to the Legion. I'm glad you're with us. I don't like the looks of this place, and I'm not talking about the Stormcloaks. You too, huh? I'd much rather a straight-up fight than creeping around a place like this. But never mind all that. We're the Emperor's soldiers. We'll do our duty no matter what stands in our way, right?
Stormcloaks were already camped out around the entrance when we got here. They don't know we're here yet.
Well, that's something at least. Looks like the damned rebels got here first. No matter. We have the element of surprise. Prepare to move out. Follow me. Listen up, Legionnaires. Those Stormcloaks are here for the same reason we are. Ulfric, the Pretender, wants that crown, but we're not going to let him have it. I realize some of you may know men on the other side, but remember this. They are the enemy now, and will not hesitate to end your lives either. General Tullius is counting on us to bring back the Jagged Crown, and that's exactly what we're going to do. Let's show these rebels what real soldiers look like.
No potions. We shall do what a real Dovahkiin do, and eat every bit of food in the inventory. I think I hit one of my dudes by mistake. Alright, a crossbow. Sure, just stop the battle to loot the dead. Another crossbow.
Well done. They never knew what hit them. But don't underestimate the Stormcloaks. Many are Legion veterans. They may be traitors, but they know how to fight. We had the advantage of surprise this time, but don't expect it to last. Let's move out.